bad attitude. For Psycho Sid, it's second nature. For Shawn Michaels, bad attitude comes from being provoked.
I am not intimidated by nothing. I'm going to do what I want, when I want, because I am the super predator at the World Wrestling Federation. It's going to take more than being a man to beat me. See the game I play. I am the master.
At the Survivor Series, Sid's game was to attack Shawn's 62-year-old mentor.
What did you do that for?
Shawn Michaels acted on instinct, the honor of friendship over the glory of a title. Sid acted on a killer instinct. The Psycho era had begun.
What's done is done. I can be the WWE champion again. This is something that cannot ever, ever be replaced.
From Psycho Sid, no sympathy, no apology.
You put your ass on the apron, and then you became part of the game!
The following day, the WWF made the official announcement. The 1997 Royal Rumble would be at the Alamo Dome in Shawn Michaels' hometown, San Antonio, Texas.
March 31st was a great day for me, but one thing that would be more special than that would be to win the World Wrestling Federation Championship in the town that I live in.
The young man who trained in a tin shack just outside San Antonio was returning home to fight in front of 70,000 friends, fans, and family.
Sid, you're what I want next. In my hometown, myself and all the people of San Antonio will tear you apart.
The day I was born the man!
The verbal and physical assault escalated.
I am 6'9" and over 300 pounds.
There's going to be 71,000 kids to see me kick your 6'9", 300-pound teeth down your stinking throat.
For Sid, nothing was sacred, not even Jose Lothario's 19-year-old son.
I want to apologize for what I'm going to do.
The monster has been unleashed. But is the monster Shawn Michaels or Psycho Sid?